जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी, यमुना तीरावन चारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, जय गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद, श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद, जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद, श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, जय गौरनिताय 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 श्री श्री गौरनिताय, कृष्ण बलराम कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम, राधा श्याम सुंदरा जगन्नाथ जगन्नाथ बलदेव जय सुभद्रम, जय जय प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद प्रभुपाद, जय जय प्रभुपाद, इताय गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल, इताय गौर हरि बोल, इताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल। ग्रंथा श्रीमद् भागवत भगवद गीता की जय। सो Thank you very much, Mataji, for giving me an opportunity to serve. And I want to thank all the devotees who have joined today for this Bhagavad Gita class in this most auspicious month of Kartik. And today we are reading from chapter 6, text number 5. I'll share the screen with all of you. Okay, this is chapter 6, text number 5. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Uddharet Atmanatmanam. नात्मानं अवसादयेत् आत्मैव हि आत्मनो बन्धुः आत्मैव रिपुरात्मनः उद्धरेत् आत्मनात्मानं नात्मानं अवसादयेत् आत्मैव हि आत्मनो बन्धुः आत्मैव रिपुरात्मनः उद्धरेत् आत्मनात्मानं नात्मानं अवसादयेत् आत्मैव हि आत्मनो बन्धुः आत्मैव रिपुरात्मनः. सो विल रीड वर्ड बाय वर्ड ट्रांसलेशन. उद्धरेत् वन मस्ट डिलीवर आत्मना बाय द माइंड आत्मना द कंडीशन सोल न नेवर आत्मानम द कंडीशन सोल अवसादयेत् पुट इनटू डिग्रेडेशन आत्मा माइंड एव सर्टनली he indeed atmanah of the conditioned soul bandhu friend atma mind eva certainly ripuhu enemy atmanah of the conditioned soul. Translation: one must deliver himself with the help of his mind and not degrade himself. The mind is a friend of the conditioned soul and his enemy as well. Let's repeat the translation. One must deliver himself with the help of his mind and not degrade himself. The mind is the friend of the conditioned soul and his enemy as well. Purport: the word Atma denotes body, mind and soul depending upon the different circumstances. In the yoga system, the mind and the conditioned soul are especially important. Since the mind is a central point of yoga practice, Atma refers here to the mind. The purpose of the yoga system is to control the mind and to draw it away from attachment to sense objects. It is stressed herein that the mind must be trained, so trained that it can deliver the conditioned soul from the mire of nestles. In material existence, one is subjected to the influence of mind and the senses. In fact, the pure soul is entangled in the material world because the mind is involved with the false ego, which desires to lord it over material nature. Therefore, the mind should be trained so that it will not be attracted to the glitter of material nature. And in this way, the conditioned soul may be saved. One should not degrade oneself by attraction to sense objects. The more one is attracted by sense objects, the more one becomes entangled in material existence. The best way to disentangle oneself is to always engage the mind in Krishna consciousness. The word he is used for emphasizing this point. That is, one must do this. It is also said, manaiva manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayo bandhaya vishaya sango mukte nirvishayam manaha. For man, mind is the cause of bondage and mind is the cause of liberation. Mind absorbed in sense objects is a cause of bondage and mind detached from sense objects is a cause of liberation. Amrita Bindu Upanishad 2. Therefore, the mind which is always engaged in Krishna consciousness is a cause of supreme liberation. Om Jnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. श्री चैतन्य मनोहिष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरुन् वैष्णवांश श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पादान् सहगना ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुवेव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिते नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। सो वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज वंस अगेन फॉर जॉइनिंग इन टुडेज क्लास। सो भगवद गीता एवरी वर्स इज सो वंडरफुल एंड इट हैज बिकम मोर वंडरफुल एंड इट हैज बिकम स्वीटर बाय द ब्यूटिफुल पर्पट स्पेशल प्रभुपाद। So therefore, purports are very important for us. So in this verse, Krishna is saying that how one must deliver himself with the help of his mind and not degrade himself. The mind is a friend of the conditioned soul and his enemy as well. Same substance, mind. As we all know that our body is made of five gross elements: earth, water, air, fire, and ether. The body that we can touch and feel is called gross body. Then there's a subtle body, which is mind, intelligence, and false ego, which we can't see, but we can feel it. So mind is a place where we have all the emotions, we have all the desires and likings, dislikings, and intelligence is the one that discriminates, you know, the power of discrimination. False ego is that what gives us the false identity that I am this body. So these are the subtle elements, and beyond this gross and subtle element is the soul. And Srila Prabhupada explains that in Sanskrit the word atma can refer to body, can refer to mind, and also can refer to soul. So you can see in this verse it is said atma eva hi atmano bandhur. So that means atma can be atma's friend. So that means one atma refers to the mind, another atma refers to soul. So it is said that mind can be soul's friend, or atma eva ripur atmana, or mind can be the enemy of the soul. Srila Prabhupada says that yoga, the practice, because this sixth chapter is Dhyana Yoga. In fact, entire Bhagavad Gita talks about yoga. Yoga means linking ourselves with Krishna. And so therefore we have Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, and Bhakti Yoga. But Srila Prabhupada explains that even in Karma Yoga and Jnana Yoga, one must have element of bhakti. So in any case, for any yoga system, be it Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, or Bhakti Yoga, the purpose of yoga system is to control the mind and draw it away from attachment to sense objects. So as long as the mind is attached to sense objects, Vishaya, then the pure soul will remain entangled in this material world. So mind should be trained to be freed from the glitter of material nature. So the more one is attracted by sense objects, the more degraded he will become. There's a verse in Upanishad also, Srila Prabhupada has told that mind absorbed in sense objects is the cause of bondage. And mind detached from sense objects is the cause of liberation. Right? So mind, same mind. So mind has to be attached. So either it is attached to liberation or it is attached to sense objects. The mind is attached to sense objects, it causes more and more suffering for the living entity. And thus the mind becomes the greatest enemy. And for those who want to advance in spiritual life, they must control the mind. There's a beautiful bhajan also by Narottam Das Thakur where he says, Vishaya chhariya kabe shudha bemana kabya miheribo Shri Vrindava. He says that when the day will come, when my mind be freed from all the vishayas, sense objects. That means in conditioned state, we want to eat something nice, we want to see something nice, to touch something soft, we want to smell something that is good. It's called vishaya. That means we want to enjoy the senses, right? So, unless the mind is purified of the material objects or the material desires to enjoy vishaya, we cannot actually see Vrindavan. Although we may be in Vrindavan, but we cannot actually see Vrindavan as long as our mind is attached to sense objects. So now the most important question is that how to do that? How to, because right now, for most of us, the mind is attached to sense objects. The mind wants to enjoy this material world. So how to pull that mind away from material world and how to engage that mind in Krishna? That is the biggest question. It is not easy, my dear friends, devotees. It is very, very difficult. In the same chapter, we'll hear Arjuna will say, Chanchalam hi mana Krishna pramati balavadridam. He says, oh Krishna, this mind, you are saying, okay, control the mind. Bodo Krishna, this mind is so powerful. Huh? Arjuna will say in the same chapter, yes, in the 34th verse, Chanchalam hi mana Krishna pramati balavadridam tasyaham nigraham manne vayuriva saduskaram. Says, oh Krishna, you are telling me to control the mind, to remove the mind from all objects of sense gratification. How is it possible? I can control wind. You know, it's very difficult to control wind. Or, you know, when we have violent storm, or what do you say, these days we have a lot of hurricanes or cyclones. We call them funny, titli, different funny names. No? So, can you imagine Arjuna was such a powerful warrior? So he told, oh Krishna, I can control the wind, but I cannot control the mind. Mind is so difficult to control. Srila Prabhupada says, what to speak of ordinary people like us? It's very, very difficult to control the mind. Right? If Arjuna, 5,000 years back, who was such a powerful warrior, he was trained in such a strong way in a Gurukula. If Arjuna is saying that controlling mind is so difficult, what to speak about us? Now, in other yoga systems, how they control the mind? Like for example, in Dhyan Yoga, you know, we have to restrain the mind. We have to forcefully abstain the mind. Like Buddhist, I have never practiced Buddhism, but I've heard that they talk about removing all thoughts from the mind. Their aim is to come to a state of thoughtlessness. So what they do is, they analyze the mind. Okay, in 1 minute, they sit in meditation. Okay, 1 minute, what all thoughts came in the mind? Okay, in 1 second, what thoughts came? So like that, they try to analyze that what thoughts are coming in the mind, and they want to make the mind thoughtless. Now that is almost impossible. Very, very difficult to do. Because the nature of the mind is to think of something. How can you be thoughtless? Right? That is, in one sense, committing spiritual suicide. So, but the beauty of Bhakti Yoga is that we are taught to engage the mind in Krishna. Savai mana Krishna padaravindu. Otherwise, it's very, very difficult to control the mind. It's not easy. Great sages like Vishwamitra, who did sacrifice for thousands of years, they got agitated just by the tinkling anklets of Menaka. So like that, we have examples of many great sages and rishis who got agitated. Savari Muni, he was under Yamuna for thousands of years, and he saw two fishes mating and his mind got disturbed. So it's not at all easy to control the mind. It's very, very difficult. But there is one simple way. When we engage the mind in Krishna, that's what Krishna will say in Bhagavad Gita two times. In the end of 9th chapter and in 18th chapter, Krishna says, Man mana bhava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. So man mana, think of me. So that is the easiest way. That's the best way to control the mind. To always think of Krishna. So we are very fortunate that we have come to this process of Bhakti Yoga. But honestly speaking, is it still easy to control the mind? At least I am not finding it so easy. Yes, compared to other yoga systems, it is easy. But still, even in Bhakti Yoga, to think of Krishna, we need to endeavor. Therefore, Krishna says in the 35th, let me show the 35th verse of this chapter. So when Arjuna says the mind is restless, turbulent, obstinate, and very strong, O Krishna, and to subdue it, I think, is more difficult than controlling the wind. Then Krishna says, O mighty son of Kunti, it is undoubtedly very difficult to curb the restless mind. It's possible by suitable practice and detachment. You have to practice. So Krishna didn't say, okay, the mind is turbulent, don't control the mind. No. Krishna is saying, yes, it is difficult, but it is possible with suitable practice and detachment. The exact words are, Shri Bhagavan Vasha, Asamshayam Mahabhavo Mano Durnigraham Chalam Abhyasena Tu Kaunteya Vairagyena Cha Grihyate. So by Abhyas and Vairagya, by practice and by detachment. So what is the practice? So Srila Prabhupada explains, that is very difficult to go to a sacred place, to focus the mind on Paramatma, to abstain the senses, observe six brahmacharya, etc. But by practicing Krishna consciousness, by 9 types of devotional service, Navada Bhakti, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Atma Nivedanam, we can control the mind. The first and foremost of such devotional engagement is hearing about Krishna. This is very powerful transcendental method of purging the mind of all misgivings. The more one hears about Krishna, the more one becomes enlightened and detached from everything that draws the mind away from Krishna. Very simple. All you have to do is practice hearing about Krishna, and by that automatically will become detached. Vairagya will come. Right? Impersonal spiritual detachment is more difficult than attaching the mind to the activities of Krishna. This is practical because by hearing about Krishna, one automatically becomes attached to the Supreme Spirit. This attachment is of Pareshanubhava, spiritual satisfaction. Just like the feeling of satisfaction a hungry man has for every morsel of food he eats, the more one eats while hungry, the more one feels satisfaction and strength. Similarly, by discharge of devotional service, one feels transcendental satisfaction as the mind becomes detached from material objects. It is something like curing a disease by expert treatment and appropriate diet. Hearing of the transcendental activities of Krishna is expert treatment for the mad mind, and eating the foodstuffs offered to Krishna is appropriate diet for the suffering patient. This treatment is the process of Krishna consciousness. Oh, Srila Prabhupada Purport is so beautiful. Very simple, Srila Prabhupada says, all you have to do is hear about Krishna. Because naturally, the more we hear about Krishna, the mind becomes attached to Krishna and it becomes detached from matter. Therefore, we must practice to hear about Krishna, his form, his pastimes, his names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. And you have to also have some diet, just like when you get diseased, doctor prescribes some medicine. Okay, you take these medicines, and this is the diet you must follow. Similarly, a medicine is Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, and a diet is Krishna Prasadam. If you do these two things, a mind can easily be controlled. So this is what, you know, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is saying. Many places this theme comes. Krishna, again and again, he says, Mai eva manadhasva, mai buddhim nivashe. Again and again, he says, think of me, right? Also, let us today read something from Letter of Instruction, which also talks about mind control. So, in Letter of Instruction is a very beautiful book written by Rupa Goswami. It's called Upadesha Amrita. I'm sure some of you must have read this book. It's called Upadesha Amrita or Letter of Instruction, which is written by Rupa Goswami, who is one of our greatest acharyas. And Srila Prabhupada translated to English, it is called Nectar of Instruction. And so the first verse of Nectar of Instruction, Rupa Goswami tells, Vacho vegam manasakrode vegam, jiva vegam udarapasta vegam, etan vegan yuvisheheta dhira, sarvam apiman prithvim sasishyat. He says, a sober person who can tolerate the urge to speak, the mind's demand, the action of anger, and the urges of the tongue, belly, and genitals is qualified to make disciples all over the world. So this is the first instruction that Rupa Goswami says, we must control the six urges, vacho vegam, urge to speak, manasa vegam, the urge of the mind, krodha vegam, the actions of anger, jiva vegam, the urge of the tongue, udara, the urge of the stomach, and upastha vegam, the urge of the genitals. And one who can control these six urges, he is actually qualified to make disciples all over the world. And Srila Prabhupada talks about mind. He says, the restlessness of fickling or fickleness of the mind is controlled when one can fix his mind on the lotus feet of Krishna. Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela says, Krishna Surya Sama, Krishna Surya Sama Maya Hoya Andhakar, Yaha Krishna Tahanai Maya Radhikar. Krishna is just like the sun, and Maya is just like darkness. The sun is present, there is no question of darkness. Similarly, if Krishna is present in the mind, there is no possibility of minds being agitated by Maya's influence. The yogic process of negating all material thoughts will not help. To try to create a vacuum in the mind is artificial. The vacuum will not remain. However, if one always think of Krishna and how to serve Krishna best, one's mind will naturally be controlled. Such a beautiful line. If one thinks of Krishna and how to serve Krishna best, one's mind will naturally be controlled. So Srila Prabhupada explains that creating vacuum is not possible. You know, like suppose you have a glass, can you create a vacuum? No. Even if you throw out water, there will be air inside the glass. But you fill the glass with, you know, Prabhupada gives example, if you have a glass full of ink and you just keep on pouring milk and milk, and gradually what will happen? The milk will all go out and milk, you know, the ink will go out and milk will remain. So right now mind is filled with dirty things. But as we keep on filling the mind with positive thoughts, with Krishna names, by hearing more and more Krishna, all the dirty things will disappear from the mind. That is the best way of purging out all the unwanted things from the heart. By hearing about Krishna, by engaging the mind in Krishna. Prabhupada says, by thinking how to serve Krishna. You know, we are doing devotees, they are doing different services. Somebody may be teaching for Krishna, somebody may be cooking for Krishna, somebody may be preaching in different ways. So when you think of our services, that is also thinking of Krishna, right? Okay, there is one more verse. So this is the basic instruction. Then Rupa Goswami also, in the 8th verse, again talks about the same thing. Let us read the 8th verse. Tannama Rupa Charitadi Sukirtananu Smrityo Kramena Rasana Manasi Niyojya Tishtan Vajeta Danuragi Jananu Gami Kalam Naeda Khilam Iti Upadesha Saram. He says, the essence of all advice is that one should utilize one's full time, 24 hours a day, in nicely chanting and remembering the Lord's divine name, transcendental form, qualities and eternal pastimes. Thereby, gradually engaging one's tongue and mind. In this way, one should reside in Raja, Golok Vrindavan Dham, and serve Krishna under the guidance of devotees. One should follow in the footsteps of the Lord's beloved devotees who are deeply attached to his devotional service. So, what is the essence of all advice? That mind should be engaged 24 hours in chanting and remembering the Lord's divine name, transcendental form, qualities and eternal pastimes. Nama, Rupa, Guna and Leela. Ta Nama, Rupa, Charitadis, Kirtananu. Nama means name, Rupa means form, Charita. Charitadi means his pastimes, his qualities, etc. And we should Sukirtana, we should chant and discuss very nicely. Anusmita, in remembering constantly, Kramena, gradually. So this is a very, very important verse. And interestingly, Srila Prabhupada, just read Srila Prabhupada's purport, he's talking of today's verse from Bhagavad Gita. Since the mind may be one's enemy or one's friend, one has to train the mind to become his friend. Same thing. See? The mind may be one's enemy or one's friend. One has to train the mind to become his friend. The Krishna consciousness movement is especially meant for training the mind to be always engaged in Krishna's business. Wow, such a powerful line. The Krishna consciousness movement is specially meant for training the mind to be always engaged in Krishna's business. The mind contains hundreds and thousands of impressions, not only of this life, but also of many, many lives of the past. These impressions sometimes come in contact with one another and produces contradictory pictures. In this way, the mind's function can become dangerous for a conditioned soul. Students of psychology are aware of the mind's various psychological changes. In Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tajyantarte kelevaram tam tam evati kaunteya sadatat bhava bhavita. Whatever state of being one remembers when he quits his body, that state he will attain without fail. At the time of death, the mind and intelligence of a living entity create the subtle body for the next life. If the mind suddenly thinks of something not very congenial, one has to take a corresponding birth in the next life. On the other hand, if one can think of Krishna at the time of death, he can be transferred to the spiritual world, Golok Vrindavan. The process of transmigration is very subtle. Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami advises devotees to train their minds in order that they will be unable to remember anything other than Krishna. So this is the point. We have to train our mind. Because at the time of death, that's the final exam. If you think of something else at the time of death, finished. It's like Bharat Maharaj. He left everything. He went to the forest. He was the king of the entire planet, actually, Bharat. The name Bharata, the name of a country, actually comes from Bharat Maharaj. You know, India is something which is not the actual name. It was given by the Muslims. They could not produce the river Sindhu. They said Indu. And then from Indu, it became Hindu and India. But this is called Bharatvarsha, named after the great king Bharat Maharaj. Bharat Maharaj left everything and he went to the forest and he was meditating on the Lord, doing tapasya. But then he became attached to a small baby deer. A small baby deer was floating in the river. You know, there was a miscarriage and his mother was running in fear of a tiger and she jumped over the river and the mother had a miscarriage. And the small baby deer was floating in the water. And when Bharat Maharaj went to take his bath, he saw the helpless deer. So he brought the deer to his ashram. But the problem is that while he was taking care of the deer, he became very attached to the deer. He became so attached to the deer that at time of death, he remembered the deer. And as a result, next life, he had to take birth as a deer. Imagine, mind can be so tricky. You know, he left everything, all the opulences of his kingdom. He left, came to the forest. But ultimately, mind became attached to a deer. But the good thing is in bhakti is that whatever devotional service we do is never lost. So whatever bhakti he did, as a result of that, in the next life as a deer, he could remember his past life and he was very, very careful. He used to live near Sai's ashram and he used to only take prasad and hear about Krishna, and then he gave up his deer body, and then in the next life he became Jadabhara. A very great devotee. In Bhagavatam, we have a big section where Jadabharat is giving transcendental teachings to Maharaj Rahugana. And after that, Jadabharat went back home, back to Godhead. So we can see the story tells us that how it is so important to train the mind to always think of Krishna. We have to be very, very careful. Even after coming to Krishna consciousness, even after practicing Krishna consciousness, even after practicing Bhakti Yoga, still we have to be very, very careful. This mind is the biggest cheater actually. The mind is our greatest enemy. The mind will tell us that, oh, you are the best devotee of Krishna, you are such a nice devotee. But that is actually cheating propensity of mind. Actually, we should always think that I am not a devotee. I am trying to be a devotee. And we should follow strictly the principles given by the acharyas and our special master. That's the only way. No, mind needs to be controlled by a superior dictation. So you have to accept some authority and follow. Then the mind will be controlled. And always engage the mind in Krishna's business. Either chanting Krishna's names, reading about Krishna, hearing about Krishna, doing services for Krishna. If you're studying, you study for Krishna. If you're doing a job, you think that this job is meant for Krishna's service. Whatever I earn out of it, I will maintain my family and I'll engage my family in Krishna's service. So try to engage in Krishna's business 24 hours a day. And in that way, we can control the mind. And always, we should try to hear more Krishna Katha and hear Krishna's names. Prabhupada, many places he says, the best way to control the mind is to constantly chant the holy names. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada, at many places he says, that Krishna's instruction, man mana bhavat bhakto, always think of me, is the same like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction, kirtanya sadahari. There is no difference. Srila Prabhupada says that Krishna told think of me, but people got confused. How to think of Krishna? Therefore, Krishna again came in the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and made it very, very simple and clear. He said, just chant Krishna's names. That's the best way to think about Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. And read about Krishna, hear about Krishna. We have so many books that Prabhupada has given us. Entire Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bhagavad Gita. There is no dearth of literature. We have so many lectures, you know, these days in social media, YouTube. We have so many lectures by devotees in ISKCON, by Srila Prabhupada. So we should hear more and more about Krishna. We should chant more and more Krishna's holy name. We should read more and more about Krishna. And then gradually the mind will be engaged in Krishna. So in this purport, the last point today before we end the class. So, So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur has commented as follows upon this verse. One who has not yet developed interest in Krishna consciousness should give up all material motives and train his mind by following the progressive regulative principles, namely chanting and remembering Krishna and his name, form, quality, pastimes, and so forth. In this way, after developing a taste for such things, one should try to live in Vrindavan and pass his time constantly remembering Krishna's name, fame, pastimes, and qualities under the direction and protection of an expert devotee. This is the sum and substance of all instructions regarding the cultivation of devotional service. So in the neophyte stage, one always is hearing Krishna Katha. This is called Shravana Dasa, that by constantly hearing the transcendental holy name of Krishna and hearing of his transcendental form, qualities, pastimes, one can attain to the stage of acceptance called Varana Dasha. When one attains this stage, he becomes attached to the hearing of Krishna Katha. When one is able to chant in ecstasy, he attains the stage of Smarana Avastha, the stage of remembering. Recollecting, absorption, meditation, constant remembrance and trance are the five items of progressive Krishna Smarana. At present, at first, remembrance of Krishna may be interrupted at intervals, but later, remembrance proceeds uninterrupted. When remembrance is uninterrupted, it becomes concentrated and is called meditation. When meditation expands and becomes constant, it is called Anusmriti. By uninterrupted and unceasing Anusmriti, one enters the stage of Samadhi, spiritual trance. After Smarana Dasa or Samadhi has fully developed, the soul comes to understand the original constitutional position. At that time, he can perfectly and clearly understand his eternal relationship with Krishna. It's called Sampatti Dasa. So these are very, very high. You know, we can see that how we're in the beginning. You know, first we have to have Vishavastha Shravan Dasa. Just keep on hearing more about Krishna, chanting more about Krishna. So when we constantly do this hearing and chanting, we'll come to Varan Dasa. When we start accepting things, when we come attached to hearing, and then we'll come Smaran Dasha, where we can remember Krishna. And then after that will come Sampatti Dasha, in which we can understand our eternal relationship with Krishna. We'll get to know our Swarupa with Krishna in the spiritual world. It's called Sampatti. So we have a long way to go. So right now, we should try to cultivate Shravan Dasha. That means as much as possible, we should try to hear about Krishna, read about Krishna, and chants Krishna's holy names. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And while doing that, the mind will try to go here and there. We all know when we chant our rounds, mind always goes here and there, no problem. Pull the mind back. Krishna says, Vairagyena Abhyasena. So practice, pull the mind back and again absorb in chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. The mind may go on somewhere, again catch the mind and bring it back and try to hear the holy names. And as we keep on practicing, gradually the mind will become attached to the holy names and all our material desires will be vanquished. And then the mind can think only about Krishna. And then we'll advance to Shravan Dasa, to Varan Dasa, to Smaran Dasa, and then Sampatti Dasa. So this is a long process to go, but we have to be in the track. And if we're in the right track, then definitely we'll keep on advancing. We have got the right path, Krishna consciousness, the best, the sure shot, success. The path of success. There is no doubt about it. We just have to follow the path of Krishna consciousness very seriously, sincerely, under the guidance of a bona fide teacher. And then definitely we'll make progress in Krishna consciousness. And as told in today's verse, that mind will become our best friend and we can actually liberate ourselves from this material world by the help of the mind. So instead of killing the mind, like the other yoga system talks about, or Buddhist talks about creating vacuum in the mind. We don't create vacuum. What we say, replace negative thoughts with positive. Replace thoughts of sense gratification, the thoughts of serving Krishna. Fill the mind, absorb the mind, you know. Just fill it with Harinam, with Krishna Katha. Then naturally there'll be no more space for dirty things. With all the dirty things from the mind will go and the mind will think only about Krishna. And at the time of death, we'll be able to remember Krishna. Antakalesha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram. And then we can go home back to God. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai. So any questions, please ask a few questions. Because the class is, I'll feel happy because anyway, it's a Zoom online class. So I don't know whether you heard or what did you understand. So if you can please ask one or two questions, I'll be happy. Yeah.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Please ask.
Yeah, I'm Suri Babu calling from Hyderabad.
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Prabhu, when you are saying we always be remember Krishna.
Yes.
That would be possible when we have a devotion service or a meeting with devotees.
Yes.
But also you said while working also we should be remember Krishna.
Yes.
Work for Krishna.
Yes.
So in this point, I just need your advice because what happened, depending on our nature of job, depending on the different situations, it would not possible to concentrate on Krishna because our nature of job would be different. Sometimes we need to be give some targets, some different pressure. Sometimes we need to be harsh with people. So what is your advice in how to
remember
Krishna while working for the working employees?
Okay, thank you so much. Very nice question, very practical question. That while working, how do you remember Krishna? So,
yes.
Once I heard this story that His Holiness Tamal Krishna Maharaj, who was very dear disciple of Srila Prabhupada. So he once asked Srila Prabhupada, because he was managing a temple in India and there were so many challenges dealing with the construction labor, dealing with the police department and dealing with so many obstacles and difficulties. So one day he went to Srila Prabhupada, said, Srila Prabhupada, you tell us that we should think of Krishna, but my mind is so much absorbed in these things, you know, cement, construction, labor, permission, this, that. And where is the time? I can't chant properly. I can't remember Krishna's pastimes. So Srila Prabhupada started laughing. He said, when Arjuna, when he was fighting on the battlefield, so when he had to shoot the arrows, do you think that he was remembering Krishna's form? No. When he was shooting arrows, he was absorbed in the shooting arrows. But at the back of his mind, what he was thinking? That I am fighting for Krishna. So when you know the purpose of my activity is to please Krishna, then while doing that activity, also you are thinking of Krishna. Is this point clear? Does it make sense? So when you are doing some activity and you know the purpose of that activity is to please Krishna, then the entire activity, you are indirectly thinking of Krishna. Right? So that also becomes remembering Krishna. Okay? So this, therefore, this consciousness is very important, that I am doing this activity for Krishna's pleasure. So being a devotee, even if you are working, you should feel that I am Krishna's servant. I am doing my duty because, you know, I have to maintain my family. So I am doing that as Krishna's service, not for my sense gratification. Like people in the world, why they work? They want to earn money and enjoy. But devotees of Krishna, their consciousness is different. They want to earn money, but to maintain the family so that the family can become devotees. Whatever extra income they have, they try to engage in Krishna's service. So in that way, their job also becomes devotional service. Okay? Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. And therefore, one more point. Therefore, at least in the morning, we should definitely do our chanting every day. That is very important because it's like, you know, it's like charging the battery of the mobile. So if our morning sadhana is good, so therefore before we start our day, we start our working day, in the morning we must spend some quality time chanting Krishna's names, reading maybe one verse of Bhagavad Gita. So then if we do that strong sadhana in the morning, then that will give us the strength to think of Krishna for the day. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Any other questions? Maybe one more question, then we can end.
Hare Krishna.
Yes. Yes.
While you are mentioning that about Bharat Maharaj.
Yes.
When he was attracted with the deer.
Correct.
And he forgotten. But generally what I heard from the devotees, if a devotee forgetting in the last minute, remembering the God will come and he will tell his name in your ears. Is it true?
Yeah, you are right. That also sometimes we hear. But this pastime of Bharat Maharaj is there in Srimad Bhagavatam, and it is there to teach us a lesson. So we learn two lessons from this story. One is that we have to be very, very careful. Somebody as exalted as Bharat Maharaj, he can also, fail in his final exam. Like he also, although he left everything, went to the forest, but still somehow became attached to deer. So first lesson is should be very careful in our Krishna consciousness. Second important lesson is although he failed, but again he was given chance. So next life, he didn't forget. As a deer also remembered, his consciousness was still developed. He remembered Krishna. Then again he got another life, Jad Bharat. And then from there he went back to Godhead. So he took three lives instead of one, but he went back. So two lessons we learn. One, we should be very careful. Second, that whatever bhakti we do is never lost, it's eternal. The bhakti continues in our next life.
Okay.
And what you are saying is right, that also Srila Prabhupada says that sometimes Krishna arranges for his devotees. So that is the third lesson actually, very important, that Bharat Maharaj was alone. He went to forest. Therefore, in Kali Yuga, we recommend to always stay in association of devotees. Then devotees help us to remember Krishna. You know, we see in the lives of so many devotees in ISKCON, in the final days, you know, devotees are around them, they chant Krishna's name, they do kirtan, they tell about Krishna. So devotees help us to remember Krishna. So therefore, it's very important that we stay in devotee association.
Absolutely. Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you. Okay, so I am very grateful to all of you for joining in today's class. So in one line, I'll summarize the class. So we heard the sloka from Bhagavad Gita that mind can be our best friend and mind can be our best enemy. So when the mind becomes enemy, when we think of sense gratification, then the mind becomes enemy. And when we think of Krishna, then mind becomes our best friend. And how do we think of Krishna? By chanting his names, by hearing about Krishna, by doing services for Krishna, by planning how to do nice service for Krishna. So these are some practical ways in which we remember Krishna. And the best way, Srila Prabhupada says, as taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is to chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, thank you so much. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai. So, I hope in this wonderful month of Kartik, let us all absorb ourselves more and more in Krishna consciousness. Okay, Mataji? Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you very much, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.